Mga kapuso, it's another special episode right here on The Pod. Today we'll be joined by back-to-back SEA Games gold medalist, Mr. Nico Huelgas. I-share niya po sa ating ngayong araw na to ang kanyang storya sa sports. How he started, how he got the gold medal, and how he was able to maintain it in 2017. And we'll get an update as well on how he's doing in life right now. All on this episode of Game On The Podcast.
I like to think na parang ito na, this is destiny. I don't wanna look for another one. Gold medals are just gonna be bonuses. I lost my 2015 gold medals.
What?
What's up, sports fans? Welcome to Game On, the podcast, the first sports podcast of GMA, brought to you by GMA Regional TV, GMA Synergy, and GMA Digilab. My name is Anton Rojas.
We are on GMA News and GMA Sports on Facebook and on YouTube. We are also on Spotify and on Apple Podcasts. I am Coach Hammer Martin Antonio.
And my name is Martin Avier. Today we are joined by back-to-back SEA Games gold medalist in the triathlon. Won it in 2015 and in 2017. Now he is part of the Philippine Olympic Committee, handles marketing, and also helps out in the training of our Olympians. Let's welcome the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Nico Huelgas.
Hey guys, happy to be here. Thank you so much for having me, GMA.
No, thank you, Sir Nico, for, you know, accepting our invitation and joining us here. Pero siyempre, kamustahin ka namin? Kamusta ka, sir?
Okay naman. Pagod. Ang daming ginagawa, pero happy. Okay na yung may opportunities kaysa wala, diba? Mm-hmm. Sa opportunity.
Kasi dati, si Sir Nico, siyempre, triathlon king to. Pagod siya sa training dati. Ngayon, saan ka na napapagod, sir?
Sa trabaho.
Sa trabaho?
Okay. Adulting life na.
Ayan.
Marts, alam mo, when you introduced Sir Nico Huelgas, I think it's very appropriate because we first met after you made history in 2015 in Singapore in the SEA Games. Tawag ko pa sa'yo, pare. Then 2017, na-upgrade when you defended it, brother. Ngayon, sir na. So from his athlete and legendary era, he's now on the management side. Nico, you are the first Filipino gold medalist in the men's individual triathlon event. We wanna get back to your journey. Paano ba nagsimula yung pagmamahal mo sa sports and eventually the events that led to you becoming who you are?
Yes. Definitely, I can say that it was not an overnight success. It's a decade-long journey of trials and triumphs, but more stress on the setbacks in life. So I started with basketball and grade school, high school, bangko, and then I moved to badminton, na promote naman as a team captain. Pero I saw the lack of opportunity given the program. I saw it agad na we were only limited to city exposures. And naman pagdating sa athletes, diba? Besides the training, it's also the exposure. It's where you are being placed. So if kalaban mo lagi or mga world-class athletes, you're eventually going to become a world-class athlete, diba? So with that, nalimit ako sa badminton. I decided to move to swimming program doon sa school ko because of the program ng Bert Lozada, we were being exposed na to national championships. So I would be seeing national athletes. So na-embody mo yung kanilang style of training, style of competing, diba? And then dun, when I went to college, I continued swimming. Dun ako na-discover maging triathlete through joining an aquathlon event. So I joined the fun run. Then in-invite ako, sumama ka sa aquathlon, total swimmer ka naman. So sa aquathlon, dun ako nakita na potential na I can be a national athlete for the multi-sport category.
Wow! Okay. So you started with swimming. When it comes to the triathlon, nag-swimming ka muna. Did you compete on a collegiate level?
Yes. Elite level talaga for national championships. Mm-hmm. I competed with the best of the best in the country.
Wow!
Because of the exposure. So even if I wasn't the best, I never won a medal in swimming in high school. And then it was already enough for me to take one step further because of the exposure. You see things differently. You approach things differently.
Mm-hmm. Was it an easy transition to add a couple of sports pa. Kasi swimming, that's a good start for triathletes. But when you add running and then you add cycling or biking, ibang klase ng training naman yun.
Actually, that's also, I was surprised with that. It's almost the same.
Almost the same. Okay.
Especially because they're both endurance sports. So, kung martial arts ka, then moving to running, it's a different story,
mm-hmm.
different discipline or style of program. But with this, it was an easy transition, especially nasa endurance specialty ko sa swimming Kung sprinter ako, would have been different. But since I was doing long distance workouts sa swimming, we were doing the same thing sa bike and run.
So what was your event sa swimming?
1500. So 1500.
So definitely yun meron na. Maganda na yung aerobic base mo na ta-transition lang to the different sports.
It was a beautiful opportunity. It was a perfect one for me to finally found the sport that I'm meant to be. Mm-hmm. And it took me about 6 years of trial and error, not winning medals, just seeing being more grateful about just doing the job, enjoying the sport, and then suddenly, when I found the perfect sport, doon ako biglang suddenly, I was, medals was just flying off.
How old were you when you first participated sa triathlon?
Triathlon? 17 years old.
17.
It was a bit late for a lot of people, but perfectly. Personally, it was a perfect time. Like, if pag nagkaanak ako, I wouldn't make her or him do triathlon. After college na siguro, if ever. I'd let them do first sports muna and then slowly transition, naturally speaking. Hindi yung pinipilit mo. Para hindi ma-burnout.
Okay, I gotta ask. Kasi swimming, syempre, love mo na yun eh. Did you like running and did you like biking as well?
Yes.
You like both?
Yeah, I enjoy the endurance training of it. Especially whenever I bike with friends. A little did I know, pwede ka pala makapagkwentuhan na ba nagbabike. So yun, nakakapag-catch up ako sa mga friends ko. I enjoy the sport. I just didn't enjoy certain moments of the workouts. Parang school lang yan, di ba? Mm-hmm. Hindi mo may enjoy lahat ng subjects. May selected few, di ba, na para ayoko pumasok dito. But you have to do it to pass the exams. Ganun.
Especially for an endurance athlete, di ba? Kasi your long repetitive movements and then yung kailangan mo bumakbak. Anaerobic threshold yung babakbakin mo. So
when you did triathlon, when you entered triathlon, how hard was it training-wise? Kasi biglang times 3 na yung pinaghahandaan mo. Nagulat ka ba noon? Or ikaw ba nalito ka dun sa... Or kinailangan ba ng katawan mo mag-adjust to that type of training and exposure?
Definitely. It was one of the most difficult transitions for me. Kasi usually when we were swimmers, we would just train once a day, 5:30 in the morning up till 7:30. But now I also have to do an afternoon session. So tulog talaga ako sa library sa lunchtime.
sa library
is the favorite place to go. You suddenly tend to be more selective with your time with people because you want to use that time to recover. That's one. And then second, he suddenly become more tired na talaga every day, and he just wanna step away from the scenery.
How did you adjust? Kasi nung nag-aaral ka, you were training, how were you able to balance it? Kasi iba pagka isang sport lang di ba? Yung mornings, usually student athletes mornings sa practice, but you have an afternoon session. How were you able to balance these things?
First off, lunchtime talaga, I don't see people anymore. I don't eat lunch with friends anymore. And yes, I did lose a lot of friends because of it. But the true friends come out naman along the journey. Yung the ones that will align with your with your direction in life. But lunchtime is my time to actually rest. Eat alone, like 5 minutes lang, 10 minutes, and then use the time to nap, to recover the mind and body. And then prepare another again for school. Ganun. Tapos sa hapon, and then yun. Ganun pa rin.
Sir Nico, you mentioned the library. I can confirm that it's a good place to sleep.
Kala ko nakita mo siya dun eh.
Where did you go to school?
So hindi niya inabutan yung happy tea?
Inabutan niya.
Naabutan niya. So not of a active participant.
Accounted for. Ang schedule yun nung happy tea sa training.
Participant or non-active participant of the
social participant?
Social participant. Parehas kayo.
Alright, so... with regards to that, correct me if I'm wrong with my background my backgrounder on you. So DLSU, swimming and track and field team. And then ngayon, maraming tao na getting into running, getting into marathons. When you joined that 5K fun run in January 2009 and you were scouted by Rick Reyes of Triathlon Association of the Philippines, did you think that that moment being scouted would launch you into being that competitive, serious guy that eventually became a gold medalist during that fun run?
Ironically speaking, I was not even gonna show up for that fun run.
No, why were you there? Why were you there in the first place?
Well, nag-cutting class na ako sa ROTC class ko.
So that was a perfect excuse.
Yeah, Saturday, it was a Saturday morning. It was a rainy one. I didn't show up for my ROTC class and okay. I didn't want to show up na nga rin sa fun run na yan. It was okay. Just 1 kilometer away from my house. But suddenly, wow. Out of nowhere, there's that gut feeling that you have to show up. And fast forward, it became destiny.
So who invited you?
That was my
you?
Biggest break in life.
I just mentioned it, bro.
Hindi, nag-invite sa'yo mismo na mag-participate dun sa fun.
Wala, nakita ko lang. Kasi every Sunday, I'd go to church and I'm like, sabi ng pare, sali kayo dito, makatulog sa mga
okay.
Okay.
For the benefit yung mga gano'n.
Divine intervention.
Bago ba yun? Tumatakbo
ka na. Niniwala ako sa divine intervention. I'm a firm believer in that.
Okay. Divine. Bago ba yun, Sir Nico? Tumatakbo ka na talaga? Or may training ka sa running?
Kasama yung ano, yung running kasama sa program ng swimming. May mga cross training kami. So, nakahasa rin yung legs namin.
Okay. What was your time? Doon sa 5K
na yun? My first 5K na yun? 19 minutes.
What? Sub-20?
Kondisyon, endurance athlete niya. Kasi swimming eh. So, yung anaerobic, yung aerobic capacity mo is there na. So, kaya mong isustain yung takbo.
I just found out the time when the coach told me because I didn't have the watch. It was
ayaw mo na mag-ROTC. Divine intervention. Gold medals. Delayed gratification.
Grabe ka, sir.
Okay, sa mga nagtataka kung bakit ganun po yung reaction ni Martin. Kasi he's running now. He's very much into it.
Yep.
And these days, you know, people be flexing on their social media. Mm-hmm. Oh, I ran. I finished this ranking. I established my PR. It's a thing. So I was looking at yung records ni Sir Nico. And your debut was May 10, 2010 in Subic, 20th. And then almost 4 years later, actually a little over 4 years later, May 25, 2014, Muntinlupa, you got your first place. When you got that number one ranking, like, did you feel like your level in terms of triathlon jumped that you could compete internationally at that moment? When you got your first gold medal?
Yes. I like to think na parang ito na. I think this is destiny talaga na. This is for me. And I know ito na yung tamang direction na I don't wanna look for another one.
Okay. Okay. So, Sir Nix, kasi in triathlon, I think the science there is you swim first. Siyempre, naka-horizontal ka. You bike, tapos nakapaganyan ka na. And then you run. Para gradual yung pagtayo mo, di ba? Tsaka para hindi ka pag-swimming mo, tatayo ka kagad, may hilo ka. Okay. It's one thing to do it on a solo event, on like a solo 5K event. Pero to get good times whilst doing swimming, biking, running, I can't imagine how hard the training was. Kasi...
Yes, it's a lot. It's a very different dynamic. Kasi people would try to gauge a talent of a triathlete through individual time trials. I'm not a firm believer in that. I'm a firm believer in throwing them out in a one triathlon event. Kasi doon mo malalaman
how they manage it.
Yes, how do they really strategize their swim, bike, run legs.
Si Sir Nico yung LeBron natin sa triathlete, no? Sa triathlon, twice gold sa Southeast Asian Games. Sige, pag-usapan natin yun, sir. Yung 2 gold medals mo and you won it back to back.
That was very difficult.
Very difficult. Okay. And this is a very competitive region as well. Southeast Asia, you got, marami kang mga Thailand athletes, Vietnam athletes.
Highly funded countries.
Highly funded.
Yan yung term ko dun, highly funded countries. Yes.
Na nag-i-invest din. Sige, talk about the first win. Una muna, yung 2015. Kamusta yung training mo dun? At ikaw ba, meron ka ng feels na you know what? I can win the entire thing. Meron ka na bang nakikitang idea nun?
Coming into the games sa Singapore, we were sent to Portugal for 2 months. This was my first time na sobrang long-term ano, high-performance training camp led by the Triathlon Philippines Federation. So I'm grateful for them. It was millions and millions of pesos of budget. It was good. We were competing in European Cups. So we were competing with some Olympians and the best of the best. So we were coming down from Portugal straight to Singapore. Ano na, we were ready. And then something happened suddenly on my mental aspect. Nagkinabahan ako kasi I feel that mukhang mananalo, mataas ang chance ko manalo. Pero ang on my mind was, paano kung hindi ako manalo? So it was that moment na umabot ako 3.5 days na wala, literally walang tulog. Hindi ako makatulog sa gabi. Because yung anxiety, panic attacks, ganun. And then the night before the race, dun ko lang na ano, na mental self-talk yung ginawa kong technique. So the night of the race, nakatulog naman ako ng 5 hours. Okay na yun. Okay na yun.
At least meron na.
At least meron na. Dahil sa puhunan ng katawan, mm-hmm. on the day itself, I was fortunate enough to win the first gold.
Better than Martin's 1 hour.
Yo! Yeah. That's true though.
Sila Don Karen na ba yung ano natin yan? Mga but sports site natin.
Wala pang sports site.
Wala pang MSAS.
And he swam.
Wala pang mga ganon. And you know what?
And he won the gold.
It's crazy. But yeah, after winning that gold and experiencing what you mentioned about sports psychology, dun ko na-realize that the pinaka-crucial thing na during the games is actually the mental aspect.
Yeah.
And it's a huge investment pala na kailangan.
Totoo.
You need to have a psychologist. I'm just fortunate because I can talk to myself. Nagawang, dinoktor ko sarili ko in short. Okay. Pero what about the other athletes na hindi kayang makope yung ganitong pressure on a big games? Especially if we know they can win. And you know what? That's actually the problem for boxers daw dati. Ang gagaling nila sa training, they would hit the sparring partners
hindi
na.
Hindi na ko-connect, no?
Oh, Olympic level na. But then, kapag laban na, hindi nila na-meet yung performance na expected. It's because of mental daw talaga.
Kaya, so parang thankful tayo kala Doc Karen niya.
So, a lot of athletes always say that it's harder to stay on top than to win the first one. We all saw the Denver Nuggets recently. Couldn't defend the championship. You defended your gold medal. How did you do it? Like, in your experience, what advice can you give to athletes defending their crown?
Before that, shout out sa mga nakalaban ni Sir Nico noong 2015. Nag-gold medal siya. 5 oras lang ang tulog. Oh, di ba? Okay, go ahead, Sir Nix.
Yes, to stay on top, it's very difficult. More than achieving, being on top, the maintenance part is the most difficult kasi burnout really comes. And I did got burned out for about 2 weeks the year before the 2017. But the advice ano parang I would give is to consistently seek your purpose. Why do you want to be on top? Some people don't want to be on top for the whole time. And I get it. It can be mentally ano,
draining.
Draining, mm-hmm. challenging. It might you know, give you a much worse life than having a better life kasi naging champion ka, di ba? Naging mas kinasama mo pa, kumbaga. But just and always go back to why you did it in the first place. You're not there just to be a winner. You're there to have a better life. That's why I mentioned about, you know, triathlon giving you a better life after. Pero kung nabaliw ka naman after o yung na-permanent injury in a way na you're never gonna go back to a better life, di ba? Then what is it for talaga?
Sir Nix, question lang. In the 2017 edition, because you mentioned the burnout and you've been training longer for this competition, would you say that you were a better version of yourself in 2017? Or were you more fresh? Were you better in 2015? Kasi syempre, in between na to, you know, if you want to defend the championship, mas mahirap yun. On the mental side, kasi you have to go through everything again, 2 years again of preparation. Hindi man 2 years, pero it's the same grind that you will have to go through. Would you say that you were a better athlete noong 2017?
Actually, I was. I was a more mature one. I approached the competition a little bit better. First of all, may tulog ako the whole time. Yun yung pinakauna. I had better diet, lots of vegetables, and I tailor mas naging specific na yung program ko for the tapering up to the very day of the race. And then of course, I credit my teammate si John Chicano who also I was on tag team with in making sure that we executed the plan of winning the gold medal. But I also had those setbacks prior to that. So I was just also fortunate that during that very day that I won, I had the best competition day performance. Ang ganda ng feeling ko ng day na yun, which something that you'll never ever control. So I do believe in luck. I do believe in the divine
intervention
na parang wow, of all competitions, not always good, bakit on the very big day, ganda ng performance ko.
Sakto yung kala, yung pagkaka-taper mo. Peak at the right time. It's
nag-align lahat.
Nag-align lahat. Sabi ko, wow. So kaya I'm always grateful for wherever I am na hard work and discipline can take you to far places you've never expected, but may factor a luck and gratitude.
Okay.
In the spiritual gratitude towards what you're doing. It may be any religion naman yan eh. Props to respect naman to all religions. It's how deep you believe in it.
It's part of the process of realizing your goal or achieving your goals eh. Yung pagiging grateful, you put a certain emotion behind it and then that enables you to get to where you wanna be. Okay, sir. Let's just establish the distances here. Swimming, ilang kilometro yun?
1.5 kilometers.
1.5 kilometers of swimming. Para po sa mga hindi lumalaki, napakalayo po niyan.
15 kanto pagka sa Pilipinas. Sa 15, 100 meters per kanto.
Kasi yung isang lap sa pool ay 50 meters? 50 meters. Okay, 50 meters lang po yun. Okay, 1,500 meters ang kailangan natin i-cover for swimming. For biking, how many kilometers po?
40 kilometers.
40 kilometers. And then for running?
10 kilometers.
10 kilometers. Okay.
So ang context ng 40 kilometers from our studio to Shaw Boulevard ng apat na balik.
Ayan. Okay.
40 kilometers yun. So 10 kilometers one way. So 40 kilometers.
Bakit Shaw Boulevard ang
yun kasi yun yung gitna kasi. Kasi yung susunod na dalawang yung susunod na station 12 kilometers na eh sa ano bang station to after ng Shaw Boulevard.
Luzon.
Hindi kasi yun at midpoint eh 10 kilometers.
Pwedeng Cavite or Laguna
o ano ba?
Diba? Isang balikan
eh.
Pero
all I know is I wouldn't calculate it that way.
Ako ganun. Yun kasi doon ako doon yung practices namin dati. Tapos dyan ako sumasakay na MRT sa baba.
Nagulat ako sa Shaw Boulevard.
Apat na balik.
Okay.
Sa EDSA, dire-diretso na.
Because we are in our running era. Ang dami naglo-long distance ngayon, sir.
I am.
Okay. Now that I'm going to the longer distances, you mentioned earlier, there's a lot of self-talk. Especially in the middle, yung mga 16, 18 kilometers, goal mo 21. Teka, pagod na ako. You know.
In San Pedro.
Okay, nakausap ko.
Basta hindi mo narinig yung tilaok. Okay pa yun.
Namumuti-muti na. Kukunin na ba ako? Teka. May matay na ba ako? Hindi. What kind of self-talk do you do? Kasi ikaw, times three eh. You know, swimming. I'm pretty sure you battle with your mind all the time. Swimming and then biking and then running. Anong klaseng self-talk yung ginagawa mo?
Sa training part, yes. Ang daming self-talk. I just try to think of, you know, ideas para lang lumipad yung utak. Ganang level just to survive.
So para automated ka na lang.
Automated na lang talaga. Tapos, sometimes I play music. Pero I try not to so that I can apply what I do sa competition. Kasi bawal ang music.
Music. Yes. Para even-keeled ka lang.
Pero in competitions, ironically, I never get burned out or nababaliw sa competition. Kasi the whole time, you're wide awake and your focus is, how do I maintain my perfect form for me to sustain the most efficient approach?
Less energy expenditure.
Yes. And it takes a lot of mental thinking to do that na wala ka ng oras para mapagod yung utak o ano.
Magliwaliw.
Oh, ganun. Never in my life, in all of my competitions, na sineryoso.
Tsaka may adrenaline din kasi pag race day na eh.
Competitive din. Among the three sports, dun sa three disciplines, Which did you not enjoy the most?
Swimming part.
Talaga?
Ito yung nag-start eh.
Exactly.
Woo! Why? Why? Out of... This is the irony here. Okay.
Kasi open water eh. Iba yung feel sa open water eh. Iba yung alon, intense. Tapos minsan nagsusuntukan, di ba? Nagtatamaan yung mga tao sa pool. Ay, sa ano, open water.
Okay. Ano yung favorite mo?
Running
is your favorite. Ooh.
Para excited na ako from the bike pa lang going to the run. Ito na. My favorite part talaga. Intense. Dito nagkakaalaman eh kung sino talaga yung super fit.
Yung huling palo.
Nilulook forward mo na. Yan na. Tarating na ako. Tapusin na natin to. Let's go. Okay. Nagulat ako dun ha. Kasi nag-start siya as a swimmer.
A swimmer. Yun yung base sport.
Mm.
In college, in La Salle, entering freshman, I was the only one in my batch na I didn't miss a single workout for the entire year.
Oh.
Consistency.
That's how much I really love the sport and the process. And the gold medals are just gonna be bonuses eh. Funny story ah, I lost my 2015 gold medal SEA Games.
What?
Can find it. And then, diba? And then to realize, parang, hindi yung pala kailangan. Okay na si Google.
Nakikita naman. Pag nag-Google ka na, Nico Welgas.
Kumi-kumi mga apo-apo ka, diba? Okay na i-Google na lang.
Alapin nyo na lang kung ano yung ginawa ng lolo nyo. Nandun dun yun.
Teka, kailan ba ulit yung SEA Games? May babawiin lang si...
25.
Thailand na. December.
I'm on carousel right now searching.
Baka binayin pa. Oo, nasan talaga? Kasi nakasulat sa likod eh. Triathlon, men's individual eh. So there can only be one.
Oh, hindi. Among the...
Like, may nakita ka dalawa, no? So, carousel. Sino pali yata yun?
Alin dito?
May sales agent daw. No? Oh. Sino makakabenta?
Baka na kay, ano na to, ha? Bustoyo, yung Pawn Stars. Naibenta na yung SEA Games gold medal ni Sir. Okay. Di ba ka pwede pa? Sir, ilan taon ka na ngayon?
32.
Pwede pa yan!
Giving up gold medals, at least you still have one more.
I mean, you need to update us when you find...
Mga kapuso, bibitinin muna ulit namin kayo. That's Everything Triathlon and the journey of our two-time SEA Games gold medalist, Nico Welgas. Next week on part 2 of this discussion, several serious life trials of our triathlete king.
Well, I got depressed nung natigil lahat ng pangyayari. Suddenly, I got an injury. I crashed on the bike and I broke my left arm.
Para sa'yo, what's your line in your motivational talks?
And more of his new role on the Philippine Olympic Committee.
A lot of people are looking for success in different aspects. Might be money, family, fame, diba wealth. But success can only come from doing it for the right reasons.
My name is Anton Rojas. Ako po si Coach Hammer Martin Antonio.
And this has been Martin Oviera saying thank you for watching
Game on the Broadcast!